Everyone, thank you for joining us in today's webinar. And my name is Rakshit Thakur. I am working as a lecturer in Parul University in PIETDS in Aeronautical Department. And let me tell you, the Parul University is a leading provider of innovative graduates in the Gujarat and in India as well. So today we are presenting a webinar that is titled as Career Opportunities for the Diploma Students. As most of the diploma students in final year, they are facing the difficulty that, okay, which career we need to opt for, and that will be based for our future. So yeah, we are just here with one most, you know, we can say like demanding subject with one of the greatest expert over here. So just a little housekeeping before that we get started. So if you have any question during the presentation, please type them to my number, and please write down my number, that is 94264-32946. I am repeating my number, it's 94264-32946. I'll bring them up during the presentation, and we will also have a time for the question at the end. Okay, so now without further delaying, I'll turn this screen our time over to the Gaurav Patel sir. He is our presenter today, and he is he is having a great knowledge with this particular subject, and he's very expert in that. He's in working as an international officer in Disa Education Consultancy in Vadodara. Okay, so over to you, sir. You can start here.
Thank you, Raj. Thank you very much. And thank you, Parul University administrators, for providing such opportunity. Guys, welcome all of you once again. And today's topic is related to career prospects and what are the possibilities after your diploma. I think that's the million-dollar question, I hope, for all of you. And within a month, you have to decide what exactly you're going to do. And that curiosity and confusion often prevails within the fraternity of students, even in the past. So let's start before we don't want to wait anymore. So what we have today, it's there on our slide, on our first slide only. So it's very clear. It should be very clear in front of all of you that what exactly we're supposed to cover today. So it will be in same chronology order only that we are going to cover all the topics. And hopefully it will give you some knowledge that, you know, can lead you to take a decision. So the first topic we're supposed to discuss regarding what options are available, especially after diploma. So let's start with what are the options available. Mainly three options are seen as the leading route for the students, out of which the first one would be obviously going for a degree and having, you know, further studying in the same domain. The other route that some of the students might go in this would be job. And the third one would be either you go for the self-employment. Now, that's the business one. Not much advisable once you finish your diploma. Unless you have 2 to 3 years of experience, we want students to have understanding of what is the dynamic of working environment and depth knowledge of management and managing all the stuff before you actually jump into the business. Even if you have your own business, let's say you're coming from a business family, as Gujarat is known, one of the prominent states of business and, you know, the business house, big houses. Even though if you are coming from such backgrounds, it is not advisable before you take 2 to 3 years of experience. Now let's come down to job opportunities after diploma. Not many would like to go and do a job after diploma, but yes, if a certain situation prevails, or let's say if situation demands, maybe due to financial reasons and you are the only sole earner in your home, you would like to see the opportunity after diploma. If you want to know about what are the opportunities available in job market after diploma, there will be 2 broad options available in front of you. Obviously, which one is private and the other one is public sector units. Now, when it comes to PSUs, means let's say it is government job, there are a lot of opportunities available even for the diploma holders also, maybe in different domain. Maybe electrical engineers can have, you know, multiple choices and options, maybe in railways, you know, in DRDO, in, you know, NTPCs. So government opportunities would be there, and we'll have to keep watching on the notification, and we'll have to qualify for that as well. Private on other side, we've got multiple companies and organizations and corporations who often look for the skilled worker, and especially when it comes from the technical background, be it diploma or degree. It is often in demand that they would like to bring the real skills which can match the global standard, to be honest. So yes, there are a lot of private players also available who look, who are looking in fact for the diploma holders to run their daily businesses. Beyond that, if I would like to go degree, this is the most favorable choice for the diploma students, that they can opt for degree after diploma. Now, to discuss more about that, as we know that this is the most favorite choice after diploma. Now, when you have decided to go and further opt for the degree studies, what are the options available in front of you? Now, this is a matter of analysis, basically, and which changes over time, and which often depends on the current trend and the policies of respective government as well. So what are the current things are going on? We'll have a quick look on that one so that you will get a little idea about everything. When we talk about degree, first of all, you have two choices in front of you. Before deciding the course, basically, you need to decide what geographical location you would like to study. So you will have two options, mainly either you want to study in India or you want to study at abroad. Now we have also seen that the recent trend, I mean, since last couple of decades, the craze of studying in abroad and, you know, maybe settling there or maybe you want to come down back has grown immensely in India. And there are statistics and researches which shows that this demand is constantly growing for the Indian students. And the other way around, what if someone wants to do their degree studies in India? So we'll have a quick discussion one by one on both the elements so that you will get, you know, certain kind of knowledge for both of them. So first we'll discuss about what are the options available in India. First and very common options when it comes to India would be you opt your degree studies in your same stream, and which you can start directly from second year itself. So it's pretty simple. For example, if you are right now in mechanical engineering, you are doing diploma in mechanical engineering, you can get directly admission in second year of degree in any, you know, good institutions in India. Now, my real interest, which I would like to, you know, mention here, even to the students more or less these days, would be about diverse stream. Now, this is something which, you know, attracts employers these days. And these are more job-oriented, more than that, I would call it skill-oriented, and more diversified streams and specialized, you know, in its domain. So when a question comes in front of mind that, okay, what exactly we need to do ahead, I mean, after next, for example, a mechanical student or maybe civil engineer student have finished diploma and there is a choice in front of him that what exactly he's supposed to do or what are the options available. Now, I would like to pause here for time being for that student and would like to, you know, focused a little future from these days and would like him to think about in what role he or she would like to see himself or herself in the next 5 years. And the second prospect that I would like to ask candidate before I actually advise them would be in which area you would like to work in your engineering. And when we're talking about mechanical engineering, very broad domain where you will have to learn about many aspects and all the details and processes. So basically you will get to know about all the things under mechanical engineering, but not any of them would take you to the deeper of that particular, you know, specific area of that chapter. And that this diverse stream will give you that. So just for example, these are just for example, more than this also available these days in India. If I talk about the first one, which is water resource management. Now, this is something which is very in, I mean, which is in demand across India. Water resource management, we already know what is the scarcity level of water, drinking water these days, not only in India, but across the world, right? And when we have abundant of water and still we fail to manage those resources, be it for domestic or for industrial purposes, is something which gives rise of demanding, you know, specialized people who can manage these resources, who can develop certain technique to, you know, store the water in a safe environment. So this study for 3 years, only for water resource management, imagine how specialized you will become. And the moment student gets graduate in a particular stream, there will be so many who will be looking for your skills, be it for maybe domestic or maybe international or maybe multinational. So similarly, the other diversified stream that you have mentioned, infrastructural engineering. Now, this is again specialized stream for civil engineering. Next, aeronautical engineering. I think this is, you know, a new trend since last 10 years, aeronautical engineering. Very, I would call it, outstanding career, those who want to opt and who want to go still more deeper into aeronautical engineering. Since you've already studied diploma in aeronautical engineering, those who are into the last year, I would advise you to go and choose a little diversified and little specific, you know, course in the same field itself, so that you will get, you know, more deeper understanding of particular segment, and which is what the require of industry is today. Well, even if you want to go for, you know, bachelor of aeronautical engineering right from second year, that is still possible. But when we're talking about employment, right? Employment will definitely need to have new specified skills, if not more than that. Industrial engineering, again, is a specific skills. Manufacturing engineering. Now you see industries, the way India is going to happen industrialization across the states, the demand of such engineers would be, you know, very high in coming days. And not just that, we need precision, we need automation too, and we need perfection with considering time factor. So demand of engineers in manufacturing industry would be at high today, but it will, you know, go still more in coming days. Nanotechnology, we all are aware of how it is, you know, even mechanical engineers these days also can able to do nanotechnology. So it's not compulsory that if you are coming from, you know, particular stream. Yes, there are streams where you need to have, you know, certain basics of similar domain, but there are streams where you don't need to have, you know, brought your similar domain knowledge background. Environmental technology. Now, environmental engineer students, those who have already opted for that in diploma, rather going through environment engineering in bachelor, technology would give them more exposure and would give them more better role, I mean, little superior role than engineers, than environmental engineers. Technology, when I mean technology, it means you will have to play a role in future where you need to understand and you need to make sure the processes are implementing the way it should be or not. So basically, your role would be a kind of inspection or a kind of, you know, quality control, or maybe organization hiring you as a consultant. So wherever you find a term like technology after that, make sure that will give you more superior role compared to the engineering, which you may find in common. Biotech engineering, again, it's in demand. Petroleum engineering, extremely in demand, petroleum engineering, since we have not that much resources available in India, at Gulf, when it comes to employment, many of our engineers have gone there and, you know, have opted for the, you know, heavy high failure. Robotics and automation, still we are not at par in this segment in India, but yes, policies currently of government and the way industries are being attracted by the current standard and current policies, we can forecast that India will be no lesser than the other countries and on, even in this field of robotics and automation. But at present, India needs more resources and skills to be able to come up in this sector. Textile production engineering. Again, I mean, this is traditional, you know, field for a particular student. But if you go down to plastic technology, yes, now this is also something where we are talking about industrialization, demand of plastic. At the same time, considering sustainable development is very important. to understand the dynamics and the entire physics, and little chemical engineers can also go in plastic technology. Mining engineering, yes, this is also much more in demand these days. Again, we don't have that many options, I mean, in terms of employment when it comes to mining engineering. But if someone wants to go specifically in mining engineering, the employment and the kind of pay skills that they used to get would be immense. And rubber technology, this is something which is again can attract chemical students and maybe a blend of ID, and can opt for entire rubber technology studies and can get employment the way they want. Fire and safety engineering. Fire and safety engineering, can you believe it? The way the importance of this element has grown in our lives, maybe last 5 years down the line. What is the importance of fire and safety engineering these days? We have gone through multiple accidents, malfunctions, maybe due to human error or maybe due to, you know, machine error, and people have lost their lives. Not just lives, but along with that, a lot of properties too. And that brings the importance of fire and safety, not just only up to managerial level, but even from the point of view of engineering. Fire and safety engineering can be done for, the candidate who have opted commerce also. BSc fire and safety engineering courses are also available. And fire and safety engineering is something which is, you know, different than what fire and safety comes under BSc. The major difference would be in terms of managing. Those who are opting BSc fire and safety would work possibly as a manager or maybe as a supervisor in certain organizer. Again, very, very much in demand. But the one who is working as a fire and safety engineer would obviously working to find the source of, the bug in the, fire element, and would definitely come up with a solution when it comes to safety. And this is much more in demand. And if anyone wants to opt this field, I mean, fire and safety engineering, and if you like to safeguard the lives of people, and if you are very concerned about the assets and the properties of government and for any private sector, this is something which should attract you and which will give you technical and, you know, science related understanding of how fire and safety works when it comes to engineering aspect. Very bright future for those who want to offer fire and safety engineering. 7 year directly student can get admission, get 3 years down the line, get bachelor degree and get, super career ahead of you. And the demand of such professionals will be growing in future, in India especially. Now, I have mentioned small note over there. When you're planning to get degree in India, you also need to consider certain other aspects in order to get admission where you actually want. You need to make sure that you get good scores in your diploma. Make sure that you might require to pass through entrance examinations, right? Be it IITs or maybe NITs, right? Maybe SRM, those who are top of the line colleges or universities, maybe Thapar College, Jain College, right? MIT Pune. Now, these are the colleges, or UPES, Uttarakhand, one of the beautiful, deliverables. They would obviously would like to, have results of candidates' aptitude and reasoning through entrance examinations. So if you are planning to get admission in any of these universities or colleges, or you can go down the line on Google and can serve the kind of universities or colleges available and see if they're required to appear for an entrance exam. And if they do, better prepare in advance. Because those things will be mainly apart from your technical understanding related to aptitude and resume. So basically, these two things has to do with your decision-making skills, how you are tackling the problems, and the way that you are understanding the dynamics and the nature of working. And make sure you practice for such entrance exam much in advance. Be it for CAT also, those who wants to go after your bachelor. So we have seen in brief about what are the degree options in India currently available, and more According to me, I usually have more interest in what are the diverse streams available these days in India and what are the general things that we need to take care of this point of time for our future. Now, when we are talking about skill gap, well, when we are talking about employment in India, the skill gap is one of the most important aspects that we often find that is lack in Indian market. You speak with employers, you speak with academicians, and you will find that is a gap. Now, this is the reason why we find, you know, unemployment rise due to, you know, not only this factor. There are many factors responsible, but mainly when you try to find the statistics, you go down to the HR ministry, you know, website, and you get a whole lot of report each year. We'll get to know what number of percentage of students are being employed this year or maybe last year. And that's where the concern is every year. More than 60%, well, unfortunately, more than 60% of candidates, or probably if I want to be more specific, there is specific study, and you will get a report on HR website only. More than 60% of engineers are found unemployable in the industry. Now, this is something which raised the alarm, you know, in ourselves as well as in the industries. We need to understand what exactly skill gap is, and this is what the most important element is, be it in India or be it in abroad. So quickly, we'll have a look at what are the aspects that also we need to consider apart from our academy and for what you need to prepare in future. Obviously, I have already mentioned before, aptitude and listening, you need to have your decision-making skills, problem-solving skills up to mark when you're applying for a role which requires certain set of skills. Now, creativity. How many number of jobs that you might have gone through, possibly if you have gone through, that you have found under required skills, this terminology. Creativity, right? Now, creativity has not only limited up to media and arts these days. Creativity has also emerged into IT, into computer science, even in structural engineering, right? So, do you have that creativity in you that you would like to do, or you would like to experiment, do new things all the time? Right? So that thing can decide the role that you're applying, whether you will get or not. Risk-taking ability. Now, here I would bring one word, which is persistence. Right? When you have decided certain goal that, okay, you want to opt for certain employment at certain industry and you're preparing for that, you need to have persistence along with that. So when you're preparing for any of the employment in the future, maybe entrance examination for the, you know, lateral entry for a university, you need to have persistence in understanding the entrance exams dynamics. You need to have all the practice available in front of you, understand how exactly it works, and keep giving again and again your effort without leaving it at any point. And this is what many students have failed to understand. When it comes to employment, we have seen, well, after graduation, 6 to 8 months, they used to spend behind celebration only. And then when they start finding the employment, it takes around 6 to 8 months or maybe 1 year down the line, unless they start getting pressure from their home itself that, okay, you need to have something quickly. And that's where students drag out from their own field and they suddenly start considering whatever the option comes in front of their mind. So basically, they don't want to take a risk. They don't want to sustain on the field that they've studied so far. They don't believe in self, in, you know, in reality, in themselves, that they will get up more. So that ability we need to develop, and we need to persist, you know, in our goal, and we need to obviously work out behind how you can achieve that. Technology literacy, you need to have now understanding of what is current trend and what are the equipments or what are the softwares being used for particular industry. And you need to also, you know, at least should have moderate understanding of how to operate all those things. Resume building. Imagine students, I mean, those who all are freshers. If I talk about myself, probably in last 1 month on, we have gone through nearly 150 odd resumes. And we are currently looking for a whole lot of team to get employed across Gujarat and possibly in some of the other states too. And we have gone through 150 resumes. And believe me, 80% of resumes have gone into dustbin within 20 seconds. So that gives, and this were not the, the profile which were not educated. We have already sat on Indeed, Naukri, and all the portals that minimum standard of education we want this much. And these are the students. And, resume is your first impression, basically, how to build it. You need to understand the art of designing that as well. And along with that, it brings so many things. It gives you opportunity to convince your employer before you actually reach that. So resume building, again, has very important role when it comes to skill gap. Communication skills, the number one choice of employer. It is starting to the field. We know communication skills is the backbone of any industry, right from top to bottom. Have you done any homework on that? Can we certify these skills on our side? On resumes, many of the students do write that they have teamwork ability, they're having absolutely good communication skills, they are risk takers, just recently they've gone. But when we ask in interview, can you explain the situations in the past that you have managed such situations? Or how can you certify these skills? Well, for your academics, your certificates can certify that you have passed minimum qualification, but the skills that you are claiming on your resume, how can you certify that? There are now courses available for these things also, right? Which can equip you to breach this skill gap. So if you don't have that, and if you want to improve such skills gap, apart from your academies, seek certain courses in your city and learn that, certify your skills by having certificates relevant along with the contents that you've learned. That can convince sometime, that can win a trust of employers sometime. All right. So skill gap, when we talk about researching skills, again, very important skills these days. Those who are having researching skills can more or less win the world over a period of time. Well, some may take less time or some may take more time, but researching would obviously, let you furthering our advancement in your career. Collaborating, cross-culture. When we talk about collaborating, now we know that we are in global village, right? When we call global village, what does it mean? Global village means, in a simple terms, we can understand that now we all are one and we all are working together when we talk about corporate culture or working environment. So it doesn't matter now when you're working in Ahmedabad, for example, and you don't need to be amazed if you find your colleague is from somewhere else and the other colleague is from somewhere else in terms of different state. So diversification in your work culture and environment, how you can adapt those environments. Because you do not have exposure to another culture, you might not able to fit into those things which has diversification in terms of human resources. So yes, this is also one of the important skills which often looked by the employer these days, especially when you guys are targeting MNCs after your degree or bachelor's. So that brings up the end of our Indian options. Let's move down next to the abroad options and let's see what we have there as well for us. Yes, again, when we think about abroad, what the first question comes in our mind would be obviously what? Expense. And naturally, it comes, in any of the Indian population minds. So when you are thinking about abroad education, definitely you will think and you will pause and, okay, that how much it will be. So let me put you one statement right in front of you now. And I'll finish with that statement only. This would be a big statement. I'll put it right in front of you now. Now, that's where the opportunity now lies in front of Indian students. Study abroad at Indian cost, right? So this is not a magic. Let me clarify you. And this is not anything which we want to twist or turn something like that. But it is possible now. And we're not talking about a country which is of low grade or which has a lower economy than India. This is not the top of the line countries that you can study at Indian cost. The only thing you need to understand is you need to look things from those perception. You need to change your perception of looking at, looking towards a thing. We have 10 different doors what is happening here is we all are queuing up behind one door. We don't even know that other door is absolutely open for us. We just need to smash it. So this is what the same thing would be, that now it is opportunity that to study, and you can have your higher studies and abroad just at Indian cost. And about this, there will be different calculations are there. We don't have time right now to go into much calculations right now. So I would just urge those who are, thinking of such aspect, can contact us later and we can go in deeper about how it can be possible. Okay. Next thing we would go ahead in terms of abroad would be, why would somebody like to study in abroad? Well, possibly you might be knowing many of the reasons. But the primary reason, let me put you in the perfect way, would be dynamic courses. Now, what it means? Previously, we have just gone through the diverse courses that this is available in India. But now, what is the dynamic courses? Before I explain about dynamic courses, I'll take you through directly the examples of a kind of courses that is available in other countries since decades. So now there are a few examples of dynamic courses in front of you. I have split it in terms of stream-wise. If you can just go through the aeronautical just underneath, there are 8 to 10 that I have listed and still many more are there. Just pick anyone and try to understand what exactly you are going to learn in that. And you will come to know that, okay, this particular study is actually preparing for a particular role in the industry. And the moment you passed out from this, role, definitely there is a role available for you. You just check it, third one, commercial flight and aviation leadership. Now, this is a blend of two different skills, which is already available under aviation engineering, but not in depth. Now, here you will learn, specifically about commercial flight operations and the leadership role in aviation. Only of these two aspects, since there are a lot of need available in world aviation about such positions. 3 years down the line, you study about each of this element and you see what are your employment chances. You take the aerospace manufacturing engineering technician, aerospace manufacturing engineering technology. Now you see again same terminology there.
Wait, sir. Your only title slide is over here, so you need to change the slide. Okay. Now it is visible. Yeah, it is visible. Now it is fine.
Okay. So I was just explaining about the dynamic courses that is available in foreign countries, which are very more specific towards the role that they will be performing in future. So first and second, just if you go through that, terminology seems same, except last word, which says one technology, second technician, very diverse. These both are in role. Industry is same, but the role is an absolutely diverse. When it comes to technician, the role is more towards manufacturing and designing kind of stuff when it comes to aircraft. And when we talk about technology, your role would be more in terms of observing all the processes happening, all the prototypes that is being explained before has been performed well or not. So again, whenever technology comes, your role will be more specialized towards inspection or maybe quality control consultant and certain like that. So when it comes to technician, under technology, those people will be more. Just down the line, if you go, I would like to point out avionics maintenance. Right, avionics technology, both are again different, role profile, industry is same, but they want to prepare, this course basically want to prepare particular student for specific role, which are in absolute need, and there will be no, full in terms of no overflow in terms of employment in next 10 years. When ministry confirms that for next 10 years, certain related employment will not be going to be finished, and then only university will get, permission to open a course related to specific. So, right side, I have also mentioned a few of them for arts and design students. If some of you would like to go ahead and you can just see broadcasting radio, only broadcasting radio. You'll be learning for about 2 years. And let me clarify here, those for aeronautical, whatever they listed their time, these are 3 years courses and this is advanced diploma. So after diploma, let me clarify what exactly this degree would be. After diploma, there are two options available in front of you when it comes to foreign. One would be advanced diploma and the other would be directly bachelor's degree. But there is no any route of taking admission into lateral bachelor, same as how we are doing in India. So yes, you need to study one more year in that way if you are taking admission in bachelor. On other side, they have also made same curriculum in 3 years and that they have named advanced diploma, right? If you are opting for the two course, it will be only diploma. If you are opting for a one course, it will be certificate course. So this is the plan. This is the, you know, strategy that has recently brought in India also. In under any field, if any of you, if you have gone through our education system also has been, molded into such way that if any of you are opting for a degree, maybe 3 or 4 years, and if you have to, drop out after 1 or 2 years due to any reason, the student should not suffer. They should get at least whatever they would learn. So 1 year of study, and if you drop out, you are liable to get certificate, 2 year diploma, 3 year advanced diploma, 4 year bachelor's degree. So in that way, if you want to study abroad after your this diploma, you can opt for advanced diploma, which will be again for 3 years specific that I have mentioned here in terms of aeronautical engineering. But again, let me clarify here, it doesn't mean that there is no any, you know, normal courses available. All the normal courses are available to abroad. I have highlighted here the courses which are job oriented, which are more of specific skills related and which are in high demand. If I move forward also, you can, I mean, there are a whole lot of specialized courses that I've highlighted for mechanical, for IT, for computer science, artificial intelligence, wow, 11th and 12th. Imagine artificial intelligence has gone today from where to where. You might be knowing also, wherever you are sitting right now, around you, if you just have a glance, you might be coming across 10 artificial intelligence right now. And this industry, to be honest, let me tell you that it has not yet grown just that, 30% also in India. So yes, there is a lot of scope and the technology is coming from Western countries. So a whole lot of chances are there. Yes, sir.
You need to change the slide, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Let me doing that now. I think I'm missing.
Yes.
Right. So these are the courses that are specified for different streams, also for mechanical and for artificial, all that any computer science or IT students can opt in that one. If I would like to go to the right side, internet communication, again, these are specialized advertisement and marketing communication management. Now, these are specialized courses for those who want to just manage communication. Imagine a role which is only asking for managers who can manage communications. Now, world has reached at that level that the importance of communication has gone beyond our imagination for corporates. Let's take, for example, IPL. Can you imagine a kind of a level of communication that we have reached these days? So to manage certain communication, this level of communication, they need a set of specialized people, a team they need from where they will get, right? So all sort of things that I have mentioned here, you can go through that also. And if any of you want slide later on, we can ask you, sir, you will get the same similar slide. As we have time constraint, I cannot go, unfortunately, to each and every course, or else there are a lot of things available under this specialized course. And even I can guide you for employment for any of these courses down the line when you finish in a job. Now the question comes, okay, first, I'll just, yeah. Now the question comes for the second reason. Yes, we have started from primary reason. Second reason why we want to study in abroad would be obviously the content. We all know that the syllabus, when I talk about, when I tell content, I mean to say the syllabus. We know that the syllabus that we are learning these days in India especially, it is not able to match the global standard and the global technology, and it requires a whole lot of reforms in education, to be honest. And it has started also. We can see from the current policies of Indian government that yes, reform has started, but every reform will take place. Every reform takes place. You take 1991 economic reform, these days agricultural reform, you see. So whenever reform comes, big blast will happen. because we need to accept that, and we don't usually accept change when it comes to Indian market. But yes, education, reform in education has already been started, and we can expect maybe next 4 to 5 years, not more than that, we can also get dynamic syllabus of what the students are going. But at present, when you have a choice right after 3 months, you need to understand this aspect also. Or else what I can suggest is, if you are taking down the line similar subjects, parallelly you opt certain studies which can give you small certificates or maybe a couple of great skills which can help you to match global standards. Or else we cannot expect that, you know, any MNCs would like us to even come for an interview. Or if they are inviting, they cannot expect that, okay, you will perform, you know, do in your rounds of interview or maybe in written interview. Because that technology the MNCs are bringing are way ahead than us. And the curriculum they have gone to design that is entirely, you know, different than what we are learning here. So because of this second, two reasons. First reason why students opting for abroad study would be diversified curriculum, I mean courses, and the second reason would be content. Beyond that, many reasons are there, maybe safety, maybe employment, maybe good medical facility, healthcare. These reasons all of you know it, right? What are the primary two reasons that should be there that I have already explained? Now, which country? We have already gone through expenses can be as equal to India. We have also gone through why someone you know, need to go abroad for further study. And now again, question and confusion comes in mind that, okay, which country we should opt for? The top four countries often comes in our mind when we thought, I mean, when we start thinking for foreign education would be this four right in front of you: US, Canada, UK, Australia. So just quickly go through that industries of USA, IT, pharma, management. These three we all know, right? USA is king of the first three. In fact, management, even in aviation also, right? And space, we all know, NASA, right? When it comes to Canada, IT, obviously, IT will remain common, you know, in all four of these countries. Even management also will remain common. The different thing what you will find in Canada would be energy, right? The kind of natural resources that Canada is having, you know, down the line, or North and Central Canada, when you go up towards Alberta and towards the Yukon territory, you will find vast oil field natural resources are available on that field, and government do not have enough manpower to work on that. Imagine, let me tell you, Canada is 3 times bigger than India. Canada is 3 times bigger than India, and believe me, Canada has population half of the Gujarat population. So we can understand here the intensity of a skilled worker in need by Canadian government. In Canada, there will not be stoppages of inviting students for at least next 20 years. They have resources, but they don't have manpower. So those of you who are looking to explore your skills, especially in energy, see, when I say energy, it may be electrical engineer can qualify, civil engineer can qualify here in energy, right? It may lead to you to more specified and diverse nature of work in future. Right? Similarly, healthcare, education, aviation, obviously also would consider under Canada, and food processing. Food processing, I think, one of the interesting areas, those who are a little creative by mind, right? And food processing doesn't only mean that you need to prepare food, but you also need to consider the engineering aspect of designing the machineries required for food industries, right? Moving next, United Kingdom, the source of management studies. Today, the product, MBA, and all those things that we are, you know, having in front of us is the product of this country, management. Britishers have ruled over, you know, more than half of the world for many centuries. And that is the reason why they have succeeded till now. What is the reason? Their management skills. So if you want to learn, see, even United Kingdom have also made their colony in Canada also, and United States also. So they have taken that skills to Canada also, and United States also. That is the reason that Canada, in Canada management also you will find, and US also management you will find. But the methods and even the syllabus, even the kind of fonts that you find on your degree certificate. Let me clarify, even in India also, when you are receiving today, let's say in Amherst University, also the degree, when you see the degree and when you see the font style, I mean, That's really very sporty, right, when it comes in front of you. But that font is also been developed by Gary Keller. Okay, so management, when it comes in your mind, yes, UK, obviously, I would not call it top out of this four, but yes, you will find very, very good quality. Financial, so all you will find service sectors. UK's GDP has 80% contribution from service sectors. So United Kingdom's GDP has contribution from their service sector only, most of their GDP. So you will find all the different sectors which has, servicing demands, be it finance, so it comes banking, insurance and sort of things. Education, healthcare, tourism, aviation. Again, aviation also will come here. Real estate, yeah, that is new something. So all these things more or less also relate to the service sector. Australia, when it comes, the new sector you will find here would be mining. I would also draw your attention that mining sector can also possible in Canada. As I mentioned, you there are vast fields of oil and gas resources are available. But even when it comes to specific mining for minerals and coal would be abundant for Australia. So those who are having engineering in civil can diversify their field towards mining to be more precise and can get employment the way they want. Energy, obviously, they are also having many resources. Healthcare, agriculture and construction. These are the, their top of the line sectors that I have tried to explain you. Then there are second string countries that comes in your mind would be Ireland. Ireland, out of 10 top pharma companies in the world, you will find 8 companies headquartered in Ireland. So those who are in pharmacy related industry. Now, it doesn't mean that only pharmacy student can go there. Even chemical student, right, can also get entry there. Even IT student can also get entry in, pharmaceutical industry, be it for separate route. But there is a demand, there is industry, and the top headquarters are settled in Ireland. IT and health sector, obviously, in all developed nations, you will find. Energy, electronics. Now you see, here you got electronics as a new component. Now that is in France. Tourism, we know France, how beautiful it is to visit, maybe Paris or surrounding areas. And tourism, the way they have developed their entire tourism industries have brought their economy, at struggling high in last decade. Chemical and textile industry. Textile, we know France today also ruling the world when it comes to fashion. Right? If I'm not wrong. So when certain cities, ruling fashion industry, that textile industry has to be very powerful. So those who are textile related engineers or those who are related to even mechanical can diversify slightly their field and can make their career more job oriented. Germany, mechanical, automobile, first thing comes in your mind would be automobile, right? And that is for obvious reason. And supported by electronics, electrical also, right? And even for food industries. So whole lot of opportunities available sector-wise, we have explained here. Let's move next. Out of this, then which one to choose at this point of time? Now, at present, Canada has taken a role of leader. When we see the statistics, out of this 5 or 6 countries that I've just gone through, the top of the line country, for majority of students, I mean, out of 100 students, you'll find 60 students this month at the Ahmedabad airport, students are in Canada. So majority of, yes.
Change the slide. Yes. Yes. Okay. Exactly, sir. Yes.
Is it visible now?
No, sir. It is.
Okay. Yeah. I think because of animation. All right. No issues. I'll just explain here. I was just explaining about out of this 7 countries, the top of the line country emerged as of current trend is Canada. Not only as a recent trend since last 3 years, statistics if you see, Canada has remained one of the first choice of majority of students. We'll try to see why is that exactly. And here we'll try to explain the reason for that. Majority of students will have PR factor in their mind. I mean, when you are thinking for the United States, UK, or possibly down the line, Australia, when it comes, four top of the line countries. And if you don't want to settle in the foreign country and if you want to come back to country, your home country, then this factor should not bother you. You select any of the four countries mentioned before. But if you have a concern of settling there only, then you will have obviously concern about which country gives you faster PR and can help you to settle more faster. And as soon as you become PR or citizen of this particular country, you will start from next day itself government benefits, the benefits that they used to give to their own citizens. And that's where it happens very fast and safe in Canada. You might have not find anyone, maybe around you, maybe around your friends or families, that has gone to Canada 2 years back or maybe 2-3 years back for study and they have returned back from there. Just because they haven't got settlement there. Maybe if they have came here, it might not be because of the settlement problem. Maybe different reasons. So that factor, out of all seven countries, you will get benefit for Canada. Fees factor, when it comes to four countries, United States and all three countries that you mentioned, Canadian fees you will find little reasonable down and the highest fees you will find for Australia. Australia is the, you know, the country which has the costliest fees when it comes to university study and supported by United States. And United Kingdom would come third and the least fees you will find in Canada. So again, yes, the students will consider this factor also and they are opting for the higher studies. Visa factor. Now, when we are talking about which country has higher ratio of giving the visa, see, this also we need to consider when you are considering foreign education that, okay, out of last 100 applications, in all these four countries, which countries has given more visas compared to the other? And you will find the name there, Canada. The reason behind that would be United Kingdom and Australia's visa rules are often changing and it is more of volatile and not stable. And the reason for that is because of their, you know, local economic policies. And they often depend on multiple factors. They cannot afford, you know, bulk of students continuously for 3 to 4 years, or else it affects their local economy and local people. So that's the reason sometimes they'll open visas for the foreign students and sometimes they'll have to close. Similarly for Australia. Currently, Australia is not open, it is closed. That doesn't mean they're entirely closed. But the rules have become more strict, you know, stricter than previous one. And the UK has been open. UK was closed before 3 to 4 years. That time Australia was flourishing. So often these both countries would be changing their visa, which will not happen in United States and Canada. So when you're considering all three factors, the easy choice will finally become that, okay, Canada would be the right choice at this point of time. And those who aspire to go for the United States often route this, you know, route Canada, to move United States through Canada. If they don't want to take a risk on first time, applying for the United States. So major reason for selecting Canada that we have discussed. Now let's say about what about the jobs, sir. Now this is something which is absolutely exciting. This culture is not available in India. When you are studying 3 or 4 or maybe 5 years in India in university, you will not have chance to work in India. In fact, that trend only not there, right? That trend is available in Canada. Mostly you can start working right from the day you landed also if you are more fortunate to get along same. But we have to consider this factor for number of reasons. The first and foremost reason it would be you can earn your next year's fees. So let's say a student studying in India and if they have concern of their finance, they need to consider entire 3 years or 4 years down the line before taking an admission in India that, okay, do you have that resource? Maybe let's take SRM University, right? Chennai, Bangalore. They have for bachelor to become an engineer, maybe around 25 to 30 lakhs, including all the fees. So we need to think first only that, okay, can we manage it? Because before that, you are not going to start earning money. Whereas here, you just need to consider first year. The reason is, all the students will start making their own fees from next year's fee. Many of our students are also there. They used to help our, you know, students who used to do that. Part-time job. Now, what are the kind of part-time job is available? Before that, we also discussed about the kind of experience that you will get while part-time doing, I mean, while working during your studies. So you will not remain precious anymore because you will have to go through this, you know, kind of sometimes it irritates you when somebody tells you, oh, you are just frustrated. Okay, so that will not remain when you are studying in, you know, possibly Canada, because you have already worked parallelly and you have all, you know, passed out with a whole lot of experience in hand, maybe not in your stream, but the skills that you have acquired, that is what much matter when you are going for the employer after your studies, right? And that makes your PR or maybe residence 2 to 3 years, and that number of hours that you have worked requires to apply for PR, and that makes your thing very easy. What are the things that we need to do to get a part-time job? Very often we come across a student that often asks us, sir, what we need to do? Is it guaranteed?
Yes.
This word often used by the student, sir, is it guaranteed that we will get a part-time job or maybe employment in Canada or maybe any country? We, you know, again, we need to pause here and we need to think, is it really depend on us?
Right.
Job getting is something which you are talking about skills. Right. If you don't have skills and if you cannot able to present in front of the employer, there is nothing that anyone can do except you. So what you need to work out on, see this thing, even no one can guarantee in India also. Even IITs, when we are taking admission in IITs, IITs will not give us guaranteed in writing that, okay, you will definitely get a job. That also, they know that their duty is, you know, to deliver very good, you know, academies. Now it's students' responsibility that apart from academy, you know, apart from what you have learned in the four walls of classroom, what you will learn extra. And if you can explain this thing to employer, your chances are better. And this is where part-time job will come into picture. Apart from your studies, what's something you will learn which can increase your chances of employment after your degree can be the experience of part-time job. And that's where, that's why it is called that part-time would be very helpful. Job skills course, now what is this? Now, we have started this course for the students who are going further to study in Canada. And we are equipping those candidates, those skills which is required for majority of part-time, you know, employees right from here. Mainly customer service related jobs would be available for students initially. So what we are doing is we are preparing candidates from here itself, right from resume making to customer service modules. Interview preparation will give references to put into your resumes along with the application how to apply to certain industries. So we will prepare you beforehand and we will also make sure that even though if you are having an interview on day one when you land in foreign country, you will not have to go through anxiety or you will not have to go through any kind of difficulties. What is the process exactly that I will explain you in terms of graph? In a very simple manner I will explain. First, I have to change the slide. Okay. All right.
Yes, sir.
Okay. The process for abroad, if any of you are curious to know about that, the chart is in front of you in a very simple form that we have tried to explain. It starts with the preparation of IELTS. Now, IELTS, I think you guys have gone through what exactly IELTS is. Just an English examination, which asks us to do our communication skills so that we can go in English speaking country and we can have a cat. After that, it goes to College Offer. Following to that, fees we need to transfer. Before that, after that, we need to go for medical. We need to go for visa application and apply. As simple as that, we don't need to get more confused in, you know, all this processing and process things. Next, when we talk about IELTS, often things about quality of teaching, especially if I talk about Gujarat and Bangalore, recently I've just been, is much opposite when it comes to quality in the market. But recently we have just launched now in Vadodara our own academy of IELTS, and the Cambridge University certified trainers also would be there. And those teachers will be teaching most of the time who are trained under Cambridge, and the Cambridge are the ones who are the designer of IELTS, right? State-of-the-art infrastructures are there in Vadodara only, address you will get later, and all sort of things that we are going to prepare at this location in Vadodara. And more importantly, for our university students, for you guys, we have made small you know, stress for you, which can give you, if any of you are looking to move further for abroad studies, we have, you know, small thing to equip you. We are, even today also, we distributed so many of the things, not for the Bharat University, but the other university students. So we are giving upfront only to those who are in final year studying right now and aspire to go further and want to associate with us. And we are pretty much happy to help them in all the process that it requires. Well, it is complex process, but that's where our role comes, and we'll make sure that things go pretty much smoother for you. And the last thing before we conclude would be September 2021, admissions have already been, and not closed directly, but still 20 days are left. So those who want to go for further studies abroad, the time is there, and very less time now left. Or else you can move on to January 2022 admissions. Admissions already have been started. Last 20 days have been left for September 2021 admissions. So those who are aspiring to go further can at least, you know, get in touch with us. We'll give all the details of what exactly initially you need to do. And that is our last slide. And I hope that I have not overrun the time. And fortunately, I have gone. Yes. So that's we. Desha Education Consultants in Baroda, and we've got many branches in across Gujarat. And I'm ready for any questions.
Thank you very much, sir. And really, I was also amazed. Like, thank you very much for the surprise that you have already provided. And I am very, you know, we can say like grateful to you that you have provided such an opportunity as well as the surprise for our students. And as you said, like, sir, yes, soft skill is the most important thing nowadays, because that is what most important, how you can reflect yourself in to the, you know, other people. And that is only the way that you can say like, okay, this and many skills I have, and that will, you know, easily grant. You know, Britishers have the top management skills, and because of that, there was one saying in the, you know, past time, like, the sun never set down in the British Empire, and that is what, because of that. Okay,
definitely,
so yes, yeah, definitely, sir. So one more question that is coming, you know, frequently, most of the students that they are asking, and you know, they are picking me, is like, what are the which is the best country for the aviation you know, opportunities, or where they'll get easy opportunities for the aviation?
Okay.
Out of these countries.
Right now, when it comes to aviation, we need to understand first of all that two aspects we need to consider. First, in terms of manufacturing aircrafts, and the second would be from which country maximum pilots are coming, right? Now, if I want to tell from which country maximum pilots are coming from United Kingdom.
Yes, right? Sir. Okay.
Maximum pilots each year, and the statistics are available on the Ministry of Aviation, United Kingdom. And the second most number of pilots are coming from Canada. Each year they are producing 80 to 90,000 odd pilots, and which also includes private and commercial pilots, and which also includes the association with the private flying clubs, which is again one of the best features of the colleges and universities of Canada, which gives them exposure right from year one of flying the, you know, even helicopters and a small aircraft. When it comes to the employment, the most importantly, I would consider the maximum chances you will get either in United Kingdom and Canada. And if the PR related stuff, if it doesn't hinder in between in students' mind, United States is obviously there. But when we are thinking about United States, we have to think from the perspective of designing and manufacturing. See, Boeing is one of the best when it comes to aviation.
Definitely.
India, they've also started, not exactly aircraft manufacturing, but they have started manufacturing parts of engine, Boeing India, right? So the vision of Boeing India is absolutely super and superior compared to previous, but it will take at least down the line 8 to 9 years still to expand the way that United States or Boeing have expanded across the world. So when it comes to manufacturing and those, you know, role that students are looking for, this one is very United States is great when it comes to where chances are there of getting an employment, then Canada and United Kingdom will come in the picture.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir, for highlighting those areas. And if you can allow me to stop from presentation from your side,
please.
I can also present the screen. Yes, sir. Yeah. I hope it will be a great opportunity for all the students that they have got this much of information. So I insist you students, if you have any other query related to the career counseling or going abroad, please contact Disha Consultancy as well as sir has also provided you the address and the phone numbers. I also let him know that if he can drop down his number in chat box, so that will be also fine for the student. They can easily get the contact number from there and they'll also contact you, sir.
You want me to put in chat box, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. From down bar, you need to stop the presenting, sir. Presenting your screen. On the main screen, you need to go.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Stop presenting over there. Yeah.
Okay.
You will have the option. Yes, sir. Now it is fine.
Okay. Now I have chat. Right hand side. Okay, here I can type.
Yes, definitely, sir.
Okay.
And I appreciate your efforts, sir, over here and your continuous support. And thank you for making this webinar happen. Thank you, everyone. And thank you, sir, for being here. This is what the least we can do. And this is the token of appreciation from our side, Parallel University side. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for
thank
being
you
here
very
with
much.
Us.
Thank you very much, particularly Rakshit ji, for moderating and coordinating such an event, and which is our of need, especially for the final year grads. And we also like to thank for the management of Parallel University, and we hope that we will have long organization and in terms of the way that we both can go to that for the better future of our students. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for being here. We appreciate you being here. And we will be having our next webinar on the next week. So please do join us for the same. And updates will be, given to you on the time. So thanks again for, joining over today. And thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Have a good day, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all. Yeah.